Hey everybody, it's Gamescom 2014. Sean McGinnis and Andy Bauman here. We've just played a bit of Fable Legends over at the Xbox booth. And Andy, walking out of that demo, it was one of those awkward moments where I was like, yeah. And you were like, oh.
I was like, so did you like that?
So clearly, we're in a state of disagreement about Fable Legends. I want to know, what was it about that game that kind of rubbed you the wrong way?
Okay, good question. I'll preface it by saying, the guy said the character I was playing was very early, and okay. So maybe they just hadn't ironed out some of the, you know, playability of it, essentially. Right. But I was playing healer, and I had to stay alive and heal you, mm-hmm. because you were the tank.
I was the tank,
and the only way I could do that was pull energy from enemies,
okay.
and then shoot it at you in ticks of 100, so your health would go up. It was really, like, stilted, right?
Okay.
I'd be like, there wasn't that many enemies to pull from, and the pull rate was really slow.
So you didn't feel like you had much of an effect on the world.
And then I was like shooting at you, and it was like, that was my role. And yeah, I didn't feel like I had any effect really. And if I there's one time when everybody was dead, basically, except one guy.
Except me.
And then you revived me.
Yeah, because I was
at
the healer at
that point. And then I had a special ability where I immediately sacrificed myself and then revived everybody else.
Oh, okay.
Which that was cool.
Very cool.
And I did that. But other than that, I felt like it was just kind of a weird game.
So obviously me playing as the tank, I kind of had the opposite experience.
Okay.
Because I felt like I had like a really good impact on the world. Fable Legends, the presentation is really nice.
Yeah.
Like I was really impressed with the way that game looks and feels, because I mean animation is so much a part of like how responsive a game is. So like
Correct.
As the tank, when I swing that sword, I want to look at those little goblin archers things and have them really respond to the weight of the impact, and I felt like they did.
Okay.
And so just like the sense of movement and me using my shield, doing my shield bash and doing my sword swipes as the tank, you know, that sense of immediacy, that sense of impact, it felt really good.
Yeah,
I mean, I was surprisingly enjoyed it.
Well, I enjoyed the concept, which we haven't really touched on. It's 4v1.
So yeah, all right, Fable Legends, 4v1. Yeah. The four are class-based heroes. The one is the villain who's playing the game from a top-down
overhead
perspective.
Yeah.
He's kind of the dungeon master.
Dungeon keeper
so
online.
So he's
basically.
Like, he does things like, if you are running through a little choke point, he can trigger these fences to separate one hero from the others.
And I had no ability to lower the fence, whereas you could smash
it
with your sword.
Yeah.
So that's
yeah.
kind of a class-based disadvantage. So if I was isolated as the healer, that would be bad news for
yeah.
everybody.
Well, I mean, at this point, it seems like there's probably one big takeaway here, which is Fable Legends still has some balancing issues to work out. If you happen to be on the good side of that balancing issue, you're going to have a great time with it. On Andy's side, maybe not so much, but hopefully they get that figured out, because there's definitely some stuff about that game that I think both of us enjoyed. So, you know,
stay tuned, I guess.
Stay tuned. We'll find out more down the line.